Yes. All right, this hand's actually pretty sick. Opponent mulliganing. Kind of almost makes me want to open with Thoughtseize, but I'm gonna go turn one Birds of Paradise, turn two Domri instead. Fauna Shaman. All right, maybe I just go Fauna Shaman Thoughtseize instead of the Domri. The nice thing about the Domri is that it like ensures that I hit my land drops. I don't know. It's tricky. Yeah, I'm gonna Thoughtseize him. Two power plants, two Urza's Towers, Grove of the Burn Willows. All right. Oh my God. All right. So if we'd just gone Domri raid uptick, he probably would have like pyroclasmed away the one Birds of Paradise. But the Domri raid wouldn't have hit anything anyway, so. Let's seize a duress, which will not necessarily hit anything. Awkward. Come on, Fulminator. That's a Phyrexian arena. Ah, jeez. All right. You see, Eye of Ugin. Kind of want to surgically extract, like, the Sylvan Scrying or something. Yeah, it's pretty weird to do. Oh, I should have done this during his draw step. So if the Sylvan Scrying had been his draw, it could have possibly hit there. Awkward. All right. Quadworm Coils, three Clasms, two Relic, four O Stones, three Karn, one Fire Spout. And I'm going to leave the Sylvan Scrying in his graveyard in case we want to eat it with a Deathrite Shaman later. All right, just going land go. Pretty happy about that. Although we still don't have any pressure. Oops. And Domri's only a turn away from ultimating. And then that can start doing some crazy things. So both decks kind of stumbled here. He Klazmed my early start, and then he drew dead. Meanwhile, like, Domri Raiden and Phyrexian Arena started doing work. I kind of don't want to sacrifice this Fulminator Mage, because if he ever hits the Tron, I can take him off of it. I think that's better than hitting his Grove of the Burn Willows now. Also, if I hit my land drop next turn, I can go ultimate Domri, play this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just drain for two more. 6, plus 4, plus 4. Put him to dead next turn. The turn after I ultimate Domri, that is. Natural plays Worm Coil. Alright. I still like my line. We could send him back to the Stone Age, blow up two towers. What do I want to do here? I kind of like playing the Grey Merchant and taking up Domri Raid, to be honest. It seems really weird. Like, he would need to play a Tron piece to be able to go O Stone plus break it. And that's the only way I would like to, I would need to ultimate Domri this turn. Maybe should have done it anyway, just to play around it. Like, he's had a lot of draw steps to have a random O Stone in his hand, and then a lot of cards can randomly tutor for... Yeah, like, if this found him Urza's mine, he just goes O Stone, break it. It found him a Karn, though. And he doesn't have Karn mana. So I think we're still in good shape here. Oh, there's the Urza's mine. Yeah, we definitely should have ultimated Domri when we had the chance. Because it's just going to eat it now. Yeah. Greedy on my part. We're not dead. We still have Phyrexian Arena going on. And there's a Surgical Extraction. I like attacking the Karn with both of our creatures. You'll probably just eat the Grey Merchant, but that's fine. You can sacrifice the Fulminator Mage, blow up his mines, strip them. Now if we'd had a Domri ultimate, we would just have this game won. Which is frustrating, because it means we misplayed back there. Unfortunately, the game has lasted long enough that he's still functioning even without his Urzatron. We really need to hit like a... I don't know what wins here. Karn can exile again next turn. That was such a misplay. Not ultimating Domri. Because that's like one of the ways that we win the matchup. And then I was given the chance and I just didn't take it. Whip of Erebos. That's some good. So he really doesn't want me to crack the Fulminator Mage here. I'm going to. I guess the whip isn't actually very good because he has that relic. So maybe we should be holding this whip in our hand instead of running it out. I don't want him to just be able to like tick up Karn and gain value though. We definitely have to sacrifice the Fulminator Mage. Yeah. Very easy Karn activation from his side. Not difficult at all. And we have no ways in the deck of getting rid of it. We don't have like Murderous Redcap to draw into any of that nonsense. Could maybe still win this game with like. Yeah, I'm just gonna let that happen. Could maybe still win this game with like Phyrexian Obliterator into. Obliterator into. Dahmer Raid, but we didn't get there, so. And then he just cracks Relic in response. But it's not like we had any other line here. I guess I could have attacked Karn down to one. Doesn't really do what I want though. Maybe the whip could have come out? I don't know. Pretty iffy. But yeah, if we'd ultimated that one turn, then we would have been able to kill the Karn the turn after that. Actually, maybe. We don't even necessarily know if that's the case. Yeah, he's got lethal here, so lethal on board. Because then the Karn comes down, and instead of exiling the Domri, it could exile one of my two creatures. And then when I play the Fauna Shaman, well, they would have had double strike, yeah. And then both Fauna Shamans go with the Karn. One of them eats it. And then one of my two engines would have still been alive to win through the Wyrmcoil. All right, so match needs tight play, and I did not exhibit that, and I was punished. But it's a crazy deck. A lot of sweet things going on. A lot of different ways you can build it too. I was thinking about possibly going more in on the Devotion to Black. Like taking out the green aspect of the deck, the Domri Raids, the Fauna Shamans, the Birds of Paradise, and just filling up these slots with black cards. Yeah. Cards like more Gatekeeper of Malakirs, that sort of thing. Problem is, the Birds of Paradise is really necessary for fleshing out the early game mana so you can turn to a Phyrexian Arena. Phyrexian Arena, definitely excellent over the course of these games. I could see going up to four of that card. And while Domri Raid did some cool things, I'm not sure if it's entirely necessary. Yeah. Whip also kind of questionable. I mean, the whole deck is questionable, but it's hard to see how it could be best maximized. But I intend to keep working on it, so maybe there'll be another set of vids, probably when the deck is more polished and refined. And less of a crazy brew. Thanks for watching.